Hello everyone, I am Surbhi Meherwal, working as an assistant professor in one of the well-known college in Hyderabad. So today I am going to explain the basics of an antenna system in our communication system. So these are the contents of my explanation. First we will go through what is an antenna, introductory part. Then we will see different types of antenna in a brief. Then the fundamental parameters of antenna. There are around 11 parameters to which we will go. Now in this slide, if you see, the first diagram A is a communication system. In this diagram you can see a one transmitter on left side, one receiver on right side, and some data or some waves are flowing in between them through some kind of a media. This is the overall block diagram of a communication system. So what is the role, what is a communication system? When transmitter sends some information to the receiver through some channel or a media. Here we are talking about the wireless media. So this is the communication system. Now just see the diagram B. This is a block diagram of a transmitter. In this, if you see, the first block is there, the input is coming from some audio signal. That is a source of information. Then after that, the signal will go through some processing like amplifier, modulator process, modulation will take place. Then after that, the very last element of that block diagram is nothing but what? Antenna. So this antenna is nothing but called as a transmitter antenna. The transmitter antenna, it takes the electrical signal from power amplifier, it will get converted into the electromagnetic wave, and then it will radiate it into the media. Now in the C diagram, if you see, this is a general block diagram of receiver. Here the receiving antenna is the first element. Means here the receiving antenna will receive the electromagnetic waves from the media, and then it will convert it them into the electrical format, and then it will go to the amplifier here. That means for the further processing, so that the original data which has been sent by the transmitter will exactly will be received at the side of a receiver. So from this picture we will come to know that the operation or the function of an antenna is to convert the signal from electrical signal to electromagnetic signal and to radiate it at the side of transmitter, and at the side of a receiver it will take the electromagnetic signals from the media, then it will convert it into electrical signals and it will give it for the further processing purpose. So this is the simple working or a function of an antenna. So in this introductory part, we will call it as a very important component of wireless communication system, because without antenna we cannot radiate at a transmitter side, and at the side of a receiver we cannot accept or receive the electromagnetic signal from the media. So it is very important component in communication system. It is conducting or a dielectric in nature. The component, the antenna in hardware, it's a conducting type and it's a dielectric in nature. Then the metallic device, it is used for radiating or receiving radio wave, just we have seen in last explanation. Then it can be used as a transmitting or receiving antenna. That only I told you previously, at a transmitter side it will act as a transmitter antenna, and at a receiver side it will act as a receiving antenna. So there is a matching between the free space and wave launching system. That means it is a some, it helps to match between the free space and the wave launching system which launches the wave. Now here in the diagram A, you can see this is the at a transmitter side. The source generator is generating some signal. It is getting passed through transmission lines, and with help of some waveguide, the antenna is going to radiate or launch that waves into the space or media. So here in diagram B, the receiver side, the receiver antenna is receiving the signals, right? Then it is passing through some transmission line to get conversion into, and it will be detected at the receiver side. So that is the introductory part of it. The next, what is a transmission line? It is a conductor only which is designed to carry current over the large distance with a minimum loss. The loss, to minimize the loss, is the ultimate goal of any communication system. Then what is a waveguide? It is a device or a tube. If it is bent or terminated, it helps to radiate the energy. And what is a radiation? The radiation is nothing but what? The process of transmitting energy. These are the simple terminologies. Now there are different types of antenna available. Now the antenna types can be differentiated or classified into three types: physical, based on their physical structure, based on the frequency range of operation, and mode of application. Now physical structure means what? The what format of a physic it has. Then frequency range operating, that means whether it is a high frequency operating range, low frequency operating range antenna, or a very high frequency range antenna. That means we have lot of range of a frequency. In which range, what kind of antenna will be usable? Based on that, it has some classification. Then the mode of application of the antenna. That means in which application you need to use your antenna, like point to point communication or broadcasting application, and so on. So here in this explanation, we will just go through briefly on the different types of antenna based on their physical structure. So I am taking this explanation, or I have made this video in the brief of introductory of the antenna types. If you want any antenna in detail, please let me know. I will go through it later. So anyhow, in the next video of mine, I will go through the microstrip antenna in detail, as I am following the syllabus of some university here. So under the demand of my students. So if you want something beyond it, please let me know. Then based on the physical structure, we will see the wire antenna, slot aperture antenna, reflector antenna, microstrip antenna, and last one is array or integrated circuit type of antennas. So the first we will go through the wire antenna. Simple, wire antenna means what? It is made up of some kind of a wire. So in that very first antenna we will see is a dipole antenna. Di means two, pole means two sides, right? So it has a two poles, that's why it is called as a dipole antenna. It is the most commonly used antenna. It is simply a structure of two straight wires or a conductors. They are conductors in nature, obviously. They both are lying on the same axis, and they are fitted at the center point of that two wires. So that is called as an exciting source or a feeding element, you can call it. So it makes a symmetric dipole. If you see here in this diagram, this is the left side of that dipole, this is the right side of that dipole, this is a feeding element or a center point of it. So it is a very lightweight kind of antenna, just made up of simple wire. So in applications, it is used in radio transmitting and receiving applications. Then next type of wire antenna we will go through is a loop antenna. If you see the diagram on right side, it's simply a loop in a structure of a wire. We are making a loop from the wire, that's why it is called as a loop. So there are two types. It can be a single loop structure, or it can be turns of a wire formed in terms of a loop. So simply it is a loop antenna. The second is a helical antenna. That means we are giving the shape of helix to that wire, that's why it is termed as a helical antenna, as you can see to the right side diagram. Then applications of this kind of overall wire antennas, they are used in personal applications, in buildings, ships, automobile, spacecraft applications. Next is a aperture kind of an antenna. Now aperture means what? If you see the diagrams here in down, you will see at the mouth side there is some kind of aperture structure is there. That's why it is called as an aperture antenna. That means this mouth or aperture will help to radiate or to receive the radiation from the media or a channel. So this is also called, so this one kind of aperture antenna is a horn antenna. So these horn antennas are tapered at one end, which is the end is a mouth in simple language we can call it, through which it will accept the electromagnetic signals or it will radiate the electromagnetic signals based on the application, whether I want to use it as a transmitting antenna or receiving antenna. So this kind of an antenna we can use to broadband the signals, astronomical studies, used in microwave applications. They are also usable in aircrafts and spacecrafts also. Next is a reflector antennas. So everyone have seen this antennas, because the dish TV antennas which we are using, it's a kind of a reflector antenna only. So it's a parabolic reflector antenna. It is most commonly used, as we all know. It is electromagnetic waves are reflected by the conducting sheet. That is the use of that conducting sheet. Okay. Then the dish of a parabolic reflector acts as a mirror. It reflects the radiation from the dipole or horn placed at a focal point, which avoids the losses. Right. The exactly parallel beams are resulted because of this structure. This applications of this reflector antennas are, they are usable in radar systems, microwave communication, satellite tracking, and radio astronomy. So here just a simple picture of one big reflector antenna. Next type of antenna is a microstrip antenna. These are the widely used nowadays because of their lightweight and other advantages or features. low cost, etc., which I am going to conduct in detail in my next video. So the microstrip antenna, the name itself is a strip like a structure. As you see in the diagram, in this structure they are just mounted on a ground plane. One substrate will be there, and on that substrate there is will be a patch of that antenna which has been or which is to be fed by the microstrip feed element. So this is to be used with the microwave integrated circuit. This is a single patch antenna, so we can use it in integrate form, multiple patch on a single substrate. So that is a good thing about this type of antenna. So that means over a small space we can implement so many patch antennas. So it will be very for integration purpose, it is very good type. So this antenna has been fabricated using microstrip techniques on a PCB. Then mostly they are used at a microwave frequencies. Then consist of a batch of a metal foil of a various shapes. So here in this diagram, just I have shown the rectangular shape. Similarly, circular shapes are available. Then square shapes are also there and etc. But the most popular is a rectangular shape that we will explain in detail in the next video of mine. Then next is nothing but what applications. The applications of this antenna, they are widely used nowadays, highly used in aircraft application, spacecraft application, satellite, missiles, car, mobiles and force. Then last type of antenna we are seeing is a array antennas. Array antenna is simply a combination or integration of different kind of antennas to make a huge antenna for a high level application. So it is a set of multiple connected antennas which works together, acts as a single antenna. The signal strength increases because of this combination. The overall signal strength we can increase. It gives the high directivity and the high signal to noise ratio. So what is the high signal to noise ratio? It's a simple noise performance. The performance of a system under some noise, or how my system is resisted to the noise. Then the problem with this antenna is nothing but what? It mounting and maintenance and space difficulties are more. That means, just for example, if I use single patch antenna and if I use 10 patch antenna on the same board, so obviously the output or a directivity or the signal strength will be high for the big multipled, or we can say that the integrated antenna, right? But the obviously the same time we are facing the problem with the mounting, their space and the maintenance also. So these are the drawback of this array antennas. One example of this antenna is a Yagi-Uda antenna, microstrip patch antenna, aperture array. Array is a set of that antenna. It is called as an array. Slotted waveguide array, etc. So they are actually used for a very high gain applications where the gain requirement is very high, and mostly when needs to control the radiation pattern. And the applications of these antennas are satellite communications, wireless communications and military radar communications. Here on these two pictures I have shown the simply an array of a multiple antennas to make one big antenna to work. So now we will see the different fundamental parameters of antenna. Here all total 11 parameters which we will discuss. The first will be radiation pattern of that antenna, impedance matching of that antenna, radiation intensity, directivity, aperture efficiency, antenna gain, antenna bandwidth, beam efficiency and polarization. So first we will go through the radiation pattern of an antenna. So every antenna radiates a power or a signal. So to study that radiation of that antenna, we use the radiation pattern. So in simple language, the radiation pattern is nothing but a diagrammatical representation or a distribution of the radiated energy into the space as a function of direction. The radiation patterns are available in 2D format also and 3D format also. So basically there are divided into two types. The field patterns, they are plotted as a function of electric and magnetic fields, and they are plotted on a logarithmic scale. And the power antenna, they are plotted as a function of square of the magnitude of the electric and magnetic field, and they are plotted on a logarithmic and commonly on decibel or a dB scales. So here in these two diagrams, see the diagram A. This is an antenna radiation pattern of an antenna. Here from this, the radiation we are observing from the 0 degree to whole 360 degree. We are seeing that how, in which direction the antenna is radiating most and in which direction it is radiating less. So if you see this structure, there is a one big loop, or you can call it as a lobe. In this term we use it as a lobe. So in this zero degree direction, there is a big lobe. This is called as a main lobe. In this direction only my antenna will radiate the maximum energy or a power or a signal, and exactly the back lobe of it is, that is called opposite to that main lobe, there is a back lobe. That means, as compared to the front lobe, in the back lobe region, the antenna radiates the less amount of signal. At the same time, in between this front lobe and the back lobe, there are some intermediate lobes are available. They are called as the side lobes. So ultimately, the practical antenna radiates in all direction, as we are seeing in this radiation pattern. But out of this, it radiates more in 0 degree and medium in 180 degree and very less in side lobes. So ultimately, the energy which is radiating in the side lobes or through the side lobes or a back lobe, it's a waste energy. That means the antenna should radiate in a single direction only. That is called as a directivity of that antenna. So we need some technique to avoid this side lobes and the back lobes also, that we will discuss later. Here on right diagram, I am explaining the radiation pattern of parabolic reflector. So here, if you observe, this is the obviously the front lobe of my, or you can call it as a main lobe of my antenna. So, and next we will call it as the impedance matching. What is the impedance matching? The basically the impedance is nothing but what? It is the opposition inside the circuit to the flow of current. Then we apply voltage to that circuit. That means, if I read this, the measure of an opposition present in a circuit to a current to flow through it when voltage is applied. Suppose if I apply voltage to my circuit, then there is some internal opposition to that current which flows through that circuit when I apply voltage to it. So that is called as an impedance. Now what is impedance matching? Now just consider, I have a two pipes with me. The one pipe with a 10 centimeter of diameter and another pipe of a 8 centimeter diameter. Now if I want to transfer the water from the pipe of a 10 centimeter diameter to the pipe with a 8 centimeter diameter, what will happen? Obviously the water will get leak at the edge point of 10 centimeter and the 8 centimeter. Why? There will be taking place of a loss of that water, that is leakage we can call it. So what is the problem? That means there is no match between the diameter of a 10 centimeter pipe and the 8 centimeter pipe. In simple circuitry language, that is only the impedance matching. So what I need to do, whether I have to take the two both, I need to take both pipes with the same diameter, that means it is called as a matching. Or else what I have to do, I have to use some connector which will help me to connect that pipe of a 10 centimeter to the pipe of a 8 centimeter to avoid the loss of a water. The same in this technical term, this is called as an impedance matching. That means when I am transferring a power or a signal from one circuit to another circuit, I need to match their impedance. If I don't, then what will happen? There will be a loss of a power or a signal, which we have to avoid. That's why impedance matching is a very important phenomena. So if we consider at a receiver side, at receiver side, very first of all, antenna will receive the signal, then it will give for an amplification purpose. So there should be the impedance matching between the antenna and the amplifier at the receiver side. That means the antenna will give power to amplifier. That means the output impedance of an antenna should match with the input impedance of an amplifier. In a case of a transmitter, now in case of a transmitter, what will happen? The amplifier will give the output to the input of an antenna, then only antenna can radiate. That means in this case, the output impedance of an amplifier should get matched with the input impedance of an antenna. Understood? Okay. Now, what is a major parameter to show this impedance matching? So there is a major parameter which shows this impedance matching is called as a VSWR. VSWR is nothing but what? Voltage standing wave ratio. It's simply a ratio of a maximum peak of the maximum voltage level of a standing wave to the minimum voltage level of a standing wave. So ideally its value should be 1:1 or simply a 1. That means the impedance is, if impedance mismatching is more, the VSWR will also be more. So that is a measuring phenomena of it. The next characteristic is a radiation intensity. Now we know that the antenna plays the role to radiate the signal or a power. So what is happening, what is the intensity of its radiation, it's simply called as the radiation intensity of that particular antenna. The radiation of intensity of an antenna should be high in a desired direction. Understood? So the power, it is nothing but what? The power radiated from an antenna per unit solid angle. Solid angle is the angle of that major lobe. Then it is simply obtained by multiplying the power radiated with the square of the radial distance. Radial distance is a distance of a distance of that major lobe from the origin, peak distance. So this is nothing but what, simply mathematically given here, it is a r square into w rad, where w is nothing but what, power radiated, and the unit of this is watts per steradian or watts per radian square. So the next is the directivity. What already I have discussed, the directivity means the direction of the radiation of that particular signal by that antenna. So it should be high in a specific direction only, or a desired direction. So directivity of an antenna should be high. So what is the formula for it? It is the maximum radiation intensity of a subject antenna. What is a subject antenna? The subject antenna means the antenna which I have to use or which I have to test. 2 divided by the radiation intensity of an isotropic antenna. Isotropic antenna is nothing but a reference antenna. The isotropic antenna is a hypothetical antenna which radiates equally in all directions. We have seen the radiation pattern previously, in that there was a major lobe and the back lobe and the side lobe was there. That indicates that how the antenna is going to radiate among all 360 degree. So ideally for isotropic antenna, the antenna radiates equally proportion to the all direction, which is practically impossible. So that is the formula of directivity. The next is aperture efficiency. We have seen the aperture antennas. So what is the aperture efficiency is what? It is nothing but what, the ratio of effective radiating area to the physical area of the aperture. Now we have seen the aperture antenna. So what is the physical size of that aperture and how effectively it is radiating through that aperture area? It's simply aperture efficiency. So ideally it should be 1. It is nothing but a ratio of effective area of that antenna to the physical aperture area of that antenna. So obviously this efficiency should also be high. The next parameter is antenna efficiency. So when the efficiency or directivity will come, it should be high practically. So it is nothing, antenna efficiency is what? It is the ratio of radial power of an antenna to the input power accepted by the antenna. The power which I give to antenna to radiate, it should radiate the same amount of power which is given as an input to it. So it's a simply formula is equals to P radiate, that means power radiated by that antenna divided by the power which has been given input to that antenna. So this efficiency should also be high. Then antenna gain. So obviously gain means it's a desired quantity, so it should be high. So it describes how much power is transmitted in direction of a peak radiation to that of an isotropic antenna. It's somewhat related to directivity obviously. So what is the formula of it is, the gain is equal to antenna efficiency, which we have seen just above, to multiplied with the antenna directivity. As it is related to the direction of the radiation, so it is a formula, we need a directivity. And this gain is defined in terms of a decibel, or we can call it as a dB. So the next parameter is a bandwidth. So obviously we all know that what is a bandwidth? Bandwidth is some kind of a frequency range over which some circuit will work. So same in case of an antenna, it is a band of a frequencies, that means it is the difference between the higher frequency and the lower frequencies over which my antenna will work properly, or as it will work as a desire. So that is nothing but what, bandwidth of that antenna. Then what is a beam width? So beam width is what? It is the angular separation between the two identical points on opposite side of the major lobe where radiated power decreases to half of its maximum value. Now just see this diagram which is shown here. So here, this is nothing but a major lobe. This is the peak value of that major lobe. And if we come to exactly half value of that major lobe, these two points we will get. So the angle between these two points here, this is nothing but what? The beam width of that antenna. So here I am reading the definition again. It is the angular separation. See now, this is the angular separation between the two identical points. That means point this and point this, to an opposite side of a major lobe. So this is a major lobe, right? which where the radiated power decreases to half of its value. So suppose here it is a 1, so it will be 0.5. So that is the beam width. So next is a beam efficiency. So what do you mean by a beam efficiency? It's simply a ratio of beam area. So area under this is nothing but what? Beam area only. So it's a ratio of beam area of the main beam to the total beam area radiated. So it's simply called as a beam efficiency. So the last fundamental characteristic of polarization is the antenna is a polarization. So what is a polarization? It is a property of EM wave, that is electromagnetic wave, describing the time varying directions and relative magnitude of the electric field. I am reading again. It is a description of the time varying direction and relative magnitude of an electric field. So there are basically the antenna can have the different kind of a polarization. So first is the linear polarization, circular polarization, horizontal polarization, and then vertical polarization. So what is a linear polarization? So linear polarization, the antenna helps in a maintaining the wave in a particular direction. Linear means in a particular direction, avoiding all other directions. So that the linear polarization helps to improve the directivity of that antenna. That means in this case, the antenna will allow to radiate in a single particular polarite in a single particular direction. Okay, so obviously it improves the directivity of that antenna. Second is a circular polarization. Here, circular means the polarization will be circular, that means in all directions. So when a wave is circularly polarized, then the electric field vector appears to be rotated with all the components losing its particular orientation, right? And this kind of a orientation or a polarization is useful in satellite communication such as GPS. The next polarization type is a horizontal polarization. In case of a horizontal polarization, the polarization will take place in a horizontal manner of Earth. As we all know that Earth is not a flat surface. So obviously when if I use this polarization technique, there will be some reflection from the Earth surface to my signals. So it will make my signals weaker. So I am reading here, it makes the wave weak because my Earth is not a flat structure. So if I polarize in a horizontal direction, my signals will get reflect from the Earth surface and obviously it will cause to the loss of a signal or a weakness of the signal. So this kind of polarization is useful in transmission of a TV signals. Then second is a vertical polarization. In case of a vertical polarization, it is exactly opposite to horizontal polarization. So it is not affected by the surface of reflections because I am polarizing signals in a vertical manner, right? So that kind of a loss will not be there. And this polarization is useful for the mobile communication purpose. So these are the different types of polarization and different antenna possesses the different kind of polarization techniques. So here I have finished with my basic explanation of an antenna, then the different types of antenna. And now the last one was the different fundamental parameters of an antenna. So guys, if you like my video, make sure that you subscribe my channel so that in future, and hit the notification button also, so that in future if I upload any new video, you will come to know about it. And your suggestions, your view is very matters to me because I will come to know that whether I have to improve somewhere or you have to appreciate me in that way also. Thank you.